Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Joel Rosen. I am an adrenal fatigue recovery ninja, and today I want to talk to you about hypothyroid symptoms. So things like feeling fatigued, having brain fog, being cold all the time, not being able to lose weight, losing your hair, dryness of skin, gastrointestinal problems. These are the hallmark symptoms of hypothyroid symptoms. But today I want to talk to you about how your hypothyroid problem leads to biochemical problems and how we can fix or address these. And this requires us looking at your genetic test. So we do 23andMe testing interpretations where we look at your biochemistry and we understand how your hypothyroid is impacting some of your genetic weak links and causing the perfect storm. So for example, when we have a hypothyroid problem, one of the things that happens as a result of great T4 activity is that it helps make riboflavin activated. So B2, it helps activate riboflavin. Why is that important? It's important because activated riboflavin is a coenzyme, or it's a cofactor for helping your genes work properly. And so if you have an altered gene, you've inherited a mutated gene and mom had an autoimmunity and she had depression or a thyroid problem and grandma had the same thing, then chances are you've expressed that altered gene as well. But where FAD or activated riboflavin comes into play is if you have a hypothyroid problem, you have low T4, you're not going to be able to make the cofactor that's necessary for energy production. And there's four major enzymes that require FAD as a cofactor. The first one is MTHFR. So MTHFR is the star of the show. It's the one that most people know about. They either have a double mutation where mom and dad both had altered genes, or just mom or just dad had an altered gene, and they're not able to make methylfolate. However, if you have that altered gene and you have a low thyroid, then FAD is the cofactor for MTHFR. You're going to have a double whammy, and you're going to have reduced energy, reduced ability to make methylfolate that's required for so many 250 cellular reactions in the body. MTRR, it also requires activated riboflavin based on a good thyroid function. So MTRR, what that does is that helps methylate B12. So you could have a B12 problem on top of the fact that you have a hypothyroid problem, on top of the fact that you're not able to activate riboflavin, making your MTRR even that much more slow. GSR, that is the recycling of glutathione. Glutathione is very, very important for antioxidants. So if you have an infection, if you have inflammation, if you have heavy metal toxicities, then you need glutathione to reduce that free radical oxidative buildup. And if you have a hypothyroid, then you are not going to have the ability to recycle glutathione. Therefore, you could have more oxidative stress. That could be inflammation, joint pains, premature aging, wrinkling, graying of your hair, achiness of your joints, all that kind of stuff. And then the last one is MAO. MAO is one of our very important neurotransmitter breaker downers of adrenaline and catecholamines. So if you don't have FAD, which is a activated riboflavin from a low thyroid, then you can have problems of anxiety and stress and irritability and just adrenaline surges and just being, you know, worn and torn, basically. So those are four major symptoms: energy, recycling of B12, recycling of GSR for antioxidant production, and neurotransmitters that are genetically based that we can really help hypothyroid patients. So this is a really awesome video. I hope you enjoyed it. I would like you to watch it more and more. We do free 15-minute phone consults for your thyroid problem to be able to troubleshoot and get your life back on track. So my name is Dr. Joel Rosen. I call myself the Adrenal Fatigue Recovery Ninja, and I look forward to helping you with your adrenal fatigue nightmare. Now, if you don't know what adrenal fatigue is and you have a thyroid problem, then you've been mismanaged, I say to patients. And if you don't know what thyroid is and you have an adrenal problem, then you've been mismanaged as well. So the adrenals and the thyroids, they work together. And if you're not addressing both, then you're not going to get better. So look forward to helping you in your adrenal fatigue and your thyroid nightmare. Thank you so much.